Ladies and gentlemen, I am the Cornish Lad, and welcome to Hearts of Iron 4, the Kaiserreich mod. Today we're going to do a proper let's play. Oh yes! I'm going to play as the Communistic Union of Britannia. What is my goal for this? I don't know at the minute. I want to take over Ireland, of course. But yeah, I'm going to play as a Union of Britain. I'm going to do a full-on series, full-on let's play. Hopefully it'll be quite interesting for you lot. Let's get going. Union of Britain. What happened in Kaiserreich? Well, the Germans won the First World War. Britain and France lost. The British royal family has been exiled to Canada. Therefore, the trade union has taken the opportunity to, pretty much take over the country and rule the country. The new Britain. This is like the mass kind of description. So here we go. Are we all good? Yeah. Okay, so. After the defeat of France, the United Kingdom's war with Germany dragged on inconclusively for 2 long years. Yep, it didn't end. In this world, it didn't end until 1921. In 1921, the stalemate was finally broken when Lloyd George agreed to the German proposal of a peace with honour. While Britain's overseas territory remained largely intact, the faith of the people did not. In 1925, disaster struck. A minor labour dispute in the coalfields of South Wales quickly escalated, and after 6 weeks of rioting, looting, and pamphleteering, most of the establishment, including the royal family, had fled to Canada. A provisional government of revolutionary groups dissolved what little was left of Parliament, declared a new union of Britain. 15 years later, the Trade Union Congress still forms the centerpiece of politics and the federated and democratic union. The British people are secure on their island, content to build socialism in isolation, protected by the strong Republican Air Force and Navy, and with each country protected by its own popular militia, who act both as a reserve military and the new police. Yet with the world seemingly ready to erupt into chaos, many are starting to wonder if Britain has a duty to spread the revolution to her former colonial territories. After all, the monarchists in Canada cannot be allowed to plot against the Union indefinitely. Black Monday. So this is like one of the big events. So you know the Great Depression in 1930? This is kind of it, but in Germany's terms. On the 3rd of February 1936, the Berlin Stock Exchange stopped sinking. It plunged. Fueled by the instability of the market, panic selling erupted as soon as the stock market opened on Monday morning. It took well into the night for the teleprints to stop sputtering out the results of what become known as Black Monday. When the results had been analysed, it was clear that the situation had only got worse. The shock of this unprecedented economic catastrophe will no doubt be felt over the world. The German Golden Age has ended, for now at least. DS, after the entire fall of the First World War, the German Empire is now massive. The death of Pius IX in the Italian Federation. Yes, Italy is split in two, as I quickly show you on the side. Here it is, split in two. So there's Socialist Republic of Italy, Communistic Italy, and the Italian Federation up there. So, the death of Pius IX. All of the Italian Federation mourns the death of His Holiness Pope Pius IX, who passed... No, not ninth, the 11th, sorry. Sorry. Who passed away in his sleep after having been in declining health for the past several years. The Holy Father will soon be interred with the rest of his predecessors in the tomb of the popes until the next pope can be chosen. The Italian Federation will be ruled by the colleague of cardinals in Rome. The succession of His Holiness is made all the more important due to the Catholic Church's role in governing the nation, as well as its vehement opposition to syndicalism, a force which has divided Italy and created the Southern Breakaway Republic, or Breakaway Republic, South Italy. So, let me just quickly explain as well. There is factions. So there's three major factions. There is an optional fourth, as well, but there's three major factions right now, and they are, as I quickly continue it on, and they are here, where is it, here it is, Middle Europa, German Empire and its colonies and allies being the centre of that, which is here, Flanders Wallia, which is Belgium, United Baltic Duchy, Lithuania, White Ruthenia and the Kingdom of Ukraine. Remilitarization of Oltenia. I've never seen this one. The Treaty of Bucharest in 1918 officially ended the Valkyrie for Romania, but at a high cost. The nation was now dominated by German and Austrian industries. Oltenia was demilitarized and oil fields were leased to Germany up to the distant year of 2012. The humiliation Romania endured resulted in it devolving into a national populist dictatorship led by conductor Corneliu Codrinu, I can't say that, I'm sorry, Codrinu, I think that's it, and his Iron Guard set out to restore Romania to what they say it should have been, a titan of the Balkans. First major move conducted by is remilitarization of Oltenia, a strategic region in Wallachia with large oil reserves and a military industry. Back to the saying of this, yes. So that's the Middle Europa. It also has the pup. Oh, where we go. Ah, the Congress is done. Economic wise. I always go Maximist. There we go. Economic policy finished. Then it will come up with like internal. I know there's foreign affairs. Oh, here we are. Foreign. I always go Maximus, but it could be Canada's our mortal enemy, France's our good friend. What does that do, actually? Because if we select that, what does that do? Wait a minute. It'll be here somewhere. Oh, no, that's military. Foreign. Here we go. Foreign policy. Still gives us that chance. Done. Military, which is there-ish. Yeah, there it is. Self-defense. I put militias under the TUC, so it'll be down this way. And internal, which is here. Again, field commissioners, Grand Protector of Revolution. We lose a lot of episodic. Go. And that makes the foreign policy finished, the military affairs finished, and the eternal policy finished. Which is great. Hurrah, hurrah. So, back to the resignation of Philip Snowden. This is, again, a big one. On the last day of the TUC Congress, Chairman Philip Snowden climbed up to the podium and made a speech. He claimed that in face of massive rifts within the TUC, and due to his age, he intends to resign his post. He also pulled out the cliche time with the family bit that all politicians do. The congregation stood silent as he climbed down from the podium and made his way out of the hall. Country is shocked, and in a few days' time, the TUC will have to vote on a new chairman. We lose a bit of political power, end of. And the International Congress as well happens. I know it's quite a lot happening. But anyway, back to the factions. So yeah, Middle Europa. That's what it is. So we have the dirty Middle Europeans with their friendly chums here and there. But a bit content with the French Empire. They also have the puppets. So Flanders Wallia's being one of them. White Ruthenia, Deutsche Mittelafrika, Crete, the island of Crete, the United Baltic Duchy, the AOG, which I ain't going to fully say, and Lithuania, of course. So, with Britain's loss, the German Empire expands to Morocco, there's Deutsche Mittelafrika, over here, just north of Abyssinia, as well as just below Yemen and next to Oman. Also over here, in Vietnam, Cambodia way, in Thailand, and Malaysia, Singapore, there's the AOG. You see China cut in half as usual. And there's a little specked just over here, and a few islands here and there. You know. So that's one of the major factions. The second one is the Third International, led by Oswald Mosley, the Maximists become in charge. Here we go. Ah, yes, here we go. This is new, I think. Leaders of the CNTFAI has fled Spain. Oh, don't tell me. FIG, arrest and imprisonment. They have come to us asking for training and support so that when they return, they will be prepared to bring down the king. Yes, support them. Did they do the election then? They might not have. They might have done strengthen the kingdom. Meanwhile, the Afghan-Indian war has ended with... with, I think, here we go, the Third International. This is what I've been on about. So France has gone through with its design to hold the first Congress of the Third International, which is the alliance between France and Socialist Italy. and we, as expected, have received an invitation. It would be foolish not to send a delegation. Arthur Horner will be on its way. On his way, I mean. So yeah, that's the Third International. It's two countries, communistic countries, allied together. And the third major faction, led by the Dominion of Canada. Oh, here we go. Syndicalism in Spain. So then, this is where the Civil War ends up happening. So, Joaquín Ascaso Badria has taken the stage and elaborated the position of the CNTFAI in Spain for the Congress. The SNTFAI is the largest syndicalist party in Spain, made up of anarcho-syndicalists, moderate syndicalists, and trade unionists. The Spanish revolutionaries have been seen white terror, violent counter-revolutionary actions taken against the workers firsthand. They have come asking for support for their cause when the moment comes. Guess what? There you go. Send them out. John Jack Reed and the Combined Syndicalists. This is in America. So this also leads to a big event. American journalist, poet and syndicalist activist John Jack Reed spoke to the Congress for an hour and 15 minutes about the crisis facing the United States and the chance for a revolution in the Western Hemisphere. In the South, the American First Committees is stronger than the central government, and in the North, and the North is suffering from a depression as the West Coast prospers. If the United States were to crumble in the face of a revolution, then the exiles would be paralyzed. Pledge the support, as we are technically syndicalists, communistics. So, the Office of General Secretary, right? So, now that the new chairman has finally been chosen, many are urging to quickly choose a new General Secretary and end the period of uncertainty in British politics. So, could be him. Tom Mann, I put, because why not? So, Tom Mann it was. Defecting officers. In light of the recent demonstration of political freedom on our island, some royalist officers have defected to us, namely Adam Willis, Jen Hutton, and Valkyrie hero Jen Alexander. They could help the Republican Army and Navy with their expertise. However, while we don't have any proof, there is suspicion that some of them may have fought against the workers in the Second Glorious Revolution. We will decide their fate. Women's role in worldwide revolution, so be it then, so on and so forth, you know. Whew, I'm talking a lot. White terror. Ah, the Britannia Commune, this is in India. Now, whilst luckily it's hit India, let me quickly explain the third major faction, the Entente, or Allies if you want to call it. This is the exile lot. So, the royal family's exiled to Canada and what remains of the, as well as France. France's royal family's also been exiled into North Africa. If you can see just here, the French Republic, just there. So, they come up with, originally it was Australia, Caribbean, Dominion of India, of course, and the French Republic. Of course, since the Afghan-Indian War, Afghanistan is now part of the Entente. So, British Commune, which is Communist India, right here, you see India is split in three. The Princely Federation, the British Commune, and the Dominion of India. We will send volunteers, so on and forth. And so, as well as Madras being a puppet of the Princely Federation, of course, German Empire there, Ceylon. So yeah, India is split in three, the Ottoman Empire grows, Germany gains the Canal Zone, Egypt's independent, there's this area, Tripolitania, which is North Africa, French Republic just here. More goes on as well in Asia. So apart from having King, which is technically China, Mongolia goes on the manners against Maklik, the AOG's there, Yunnan as well, Tibet. The Fengxian government and the Transamurian Admiralty, as it is, these three are actually allies or puppets of Japan, if I'm right. Yeah, they are a puppet of the Japanese Empire, which then makes the great Asian co-prosperity sphere. This being that Japan, the Fengxian government, and Transamur, those three end up having rid of like Mongolia, King, AOG, so on and so forth. The world is a dangerous place, so we need alliances with sworn enemies of capitalism. Bolivia and Brazil could benefit from joining forces in a crusade for a new brave world. Anti-socialist warmongers from La Plata, Argentina, are seeking war to crush the successful Brazilian and Bolivian revolutions, so we need to combine our powers to defend the spoils and protect and our proletarian uprising. Yeah, alright. It's fantastic, isn't it? I can't wait to play the rest of this, because why? I love this mod so much. This is one hell of a decent mod from Hearts of Iron 4. Biggest mod ever, the most popular mod ever. Speaking of multiplayer games, there is technically one for this. Kaiserreich on a Wednesday. If you're living Central European time, or CEST, I think it is, or CET, starts at 7 o'clock at night all the way till midnight. And if you're in, the Union of Arts, yes, do that. And then if you're in Britain, if you're in the British Standard Times, that's 6 o'clock till 11 at night. How have I gained more political power so quickly then? Jesus. Infantry. Spanish New Wales, that's done. Okay, it's quite a lot now. So yeah, there is a multiplayer game happening every Wednesday. Join up if so, led by someone called The 1-2. I'm calling this the end to the first episode of the new series. Hearts of Iron 4, Kaiserreich, Rule Britannia, as it will be titled, as the, you know, Communistic Union of Britannia. I may kill Ireland as quickly as possible. I must, anyway. The reason for that will come in the next episode, which will be up very soon. But apart from that, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for watching. If you have liked it, then please hit the like button, comment down below what you think. And if you've played it before, put down your experiences. For crying out loud, I'd love to hear it. Apart from that, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for watching. And I'll see all of you lot in the bleeding next episode. For Britannia! Thank you.